Hey guys, Subject Adventure here. We've got the truck out in my friend's farm out in Sandy. I call it the Schmidt National Forest. It is an absolutely beautiful place to do a truck walk around. This is our truck. It's our adventure rig. It's our home when we're outside. It's where we cook. It's where we sleep. It holds our water, our food, and all of our camping gear while we are out in the woods. And it also just stays in the truck so we can throw in what we need and get out the door. It's been tastefully modified to fit our needs. We haven't done a whole bunch to the outside or the exterior. It's got a roof rack, some suspension upgrades, and a little bit bigger tires to get around. It's pretty much at where we want it at this point. Here's a few things we might want to do, but famous last words, I guess. We started truck bed camping many years ago. We had an old square body Suburban, and we just threw a blow-up mattress in the back of that, put in whatever we needed to go out in the woods, and camped, and it was wonderful. And we ended up selling a Suburban and we bought this 2012 Tundra. And over time we've put more things into it to make it more comfortable. Each time we go out, we realize, oh, we should do this or we should do that. We should make this or do that. And just slowly over time been upgrading the truck for comfort out in the woods. So here's an introduction to our base camp, overland vehicle, adventure rig, whatever you want to call it. It's what allows us to get out in the mountains and be safe, be comfortable, be fed, drink water, and sleep. All right guys, the first thing I want to talk about are the tires that we put on the truck. They're the Cooper Discoverer Rugged Treks. They're kind of in between a mud tire and an all-terrain tire, and we absolutely love them. They're not loud. They're pretty quiet, actually. You can kind of hear them a little bit on the highway once you get up to speed. A little bit of radio volume and the noise goes away completely. They're good in the snow, they're good in the mud. We haven't had any problems with them at all. We were out this winter in 8 to 10 inches of snow and they grip just fine. So yeah, we'll get a little closer look. One of the things that I like most about these tires is that they have a 55,000 mile warranty, which is abnormal for your standard mud or all-terrain tire. They don't have a real long warranty. So you can see they have a pretty good tread depth. A pretty aggressive tread pattern. It's not super aggressive, but yeah, it works really well. We absolutely love these tires. Second thing we'll talk about is suspension. Light mods. We added the Bilstein 5100s on all four corners. The front allowed us to lift the front 2 inches, which is kind of gives it a leveling effect. And then I put some 1-inch blocks in the rear. I'm actually going to add shackles. I have them. I just haven't put them on yet. To get a little bit more lift out of the back. Once we put all of our gear in there and water and stuff on the roof, it does sag a little bit, not too bad, but if I put some 1-inch shackles on there, it'll give us one, it'll give us a little bit more suspension travel, and two, a little bit more clearance and the truck will level out. Now we'll talk about the roof rack. The roof rack is kind of a budget deal. I actually got the rails from a 2007 Suburban from U-Pullet. It was about 30 bucks. They're 7 feet long, so I had to cut them down to fit the top of the 6.5 foot canopy. And then the roof rack we got from Craigslist. It was 50 bucks. Came off a Jeep. It had rain drip rail mounts. I took those off and custom built some mounts, basically just to clamp it directly to the roof rails. That way it had a real low profile. It wasn't sticking way up in the air. You can see that there's a very minimal gap, maybe about 1 inch between the base of the roof rack and the actual roof of the truck. I put some rubber hose between the roof rack and the roof rails to keep them from rubbing down. Then I custom built those little brackets. It holds it on there pretty good. I mean, I gathered we probably had 200 or 300 pounds on there, if not a little bit more, with wood and stuff. Up and down over bumps, it gets a lot of lift. It goes up and down. It's never come loose. It's not cracking anything. It actually works really well. We're super happy with it. We have green totes that we put up here that are not up here right now. One of them is just for garbage. It's nice to be able to go out in the woods and whatever garbage you have, if you've got a can bag, if you've got, you know, whatever refuse you have that can either smell bad or leak, just put it in these plastic bins and it can leak all at once. We get home, put the garbage in the can, and then we just rinse the bins out. There's two bins that we have. The second bin's actually for our awning room, which we also didn't bring today. And we could just roll up the awning room and put it in the bin and it's on the top. We put wood up here. It's nice to have wood that's wrapped It's already got the cellophane wrapping around it, because once you just put loose wood up here that's been cut, it's kind of hard to get it compacted and stay in place without it sliding off. All right, guys, this is the interior. Not a whole lot of mods here. I've got a magnetic phone mount to mount my phone down low. I've got an aftermarket radio. It's a Pioneer. It's very nice. I love it. It's got Android Auto, so most of my phone apps that I need for mapping or communications, texting, it'll read out my text out loud, and then I can respond vocally if I need to. But it's great to have that capability, so I don't have to take my hands off the wheel. I can keep my eyes on where I'm going. So we use Gaia for mapping, and all of our travels, everything we use Gaia for, and I have a subscription to Gaia. It's very nice. It keeps all of my pins. I can make tracks and routes. It's kind of cool to be able to use the routes. We use them all the time. I can make them a bright color, and then when my phone's hooked up to the radio, all of my routes are on Gaia on the radio, and I just follow the route that way. If we get to a point to where we want to go somewhere different, or we're just going into the unknown, then I just get my tablet out, use Gaia on my tablet that way. I can make a route on Gaia, and then it just pops up on my stereo. Works out really well. For comms, we use walkie-talkies. I do have a Baofeng. I do not have my ham license, so we do not communicate with that unless it's on other channels. But we can listen in, whatever the case may be, in case of emergency or something like that. But we usually just use little handheld radios. They work out really well. The distance, you know, the range isn't very far, maybe a mile or two. But usually when you're in a pack, you're pretty close. So those work just fine. I do not have a CB or a truck-mounted radio at this point. So now we can talk about the bed. This is basically where we sleep and stores all of our gear. It's roomy enough to where we fit fine back there, the two of us, and Luna, if she decides to come out. We have heat, so this is a Mr. Buddy portable buddy heater. Runs off of propane. You can see wrapped around there is the propane tube, and I just run that tube down and out a little grommet that I put in the bed, and then that tube runs out and goes right into our propane tank. With this propane tank, that thing will never ever run out, so it's really nice to have that heat. We don't leave it on at night. The sleeping bag sits up about this high, and if we were to leave that thing on, then we would burn. So essentially what we do is I just peel the sleeping bag back, and then we turn the heater on. We get it up to about 75 or 80 in here, and then we hop in, change, get in the bag, all while the heater is on. And once we're warm, we shut the heater off, wait for it to cool off, and then we go to sleep. In the morning, we'll just kick the bag over, turn the heater back on. Make sure a window's cracked, of course. Get it up to about 60, 65 in here, change and hop out. So we just use the heater for transitional. We don't use it to keep it warm at night. So I've wired the back of the truck off of the truck battery. I've got these guys here, which has a USB-C charger or port, and then USB 3.0 ports. And then this one here also has USB. They can all be turned on, turned off, but there's two on this side, and then there are also two in the back up in there. There's also a 12 volt cigarette lighter socket back there too. The power does power these LEDs that we have back up in here in the bed. Again, they run off the truck battery. I've never run the truck battery below 12.2 or 12.1 ever. And we've been out for 4 or 5 days before. These LEDs don't pull anything off at all. We do charge our phones. I'll charge my phone off of this one, and Jen will charge her phone off of that one. But during the day, if we're gonna charge our phones, we charge them off the main battery over there. So these are the shelves that we have back here. This is basically our only storage minus that up there. But these shelves here, they're kind of janky. It's basically like a shoe shelf that I bought from Home Goods or something quite a few years ago, and it's pretty trashed by now. You can see, I mean, it holds our stuff. We put our clothes in there when we go to bed. But eventually, and the next project is basically to build a little shelf system out of wood. And what that'll do is it'll have some cubbies, and it will rest up against the window. And then when we want to take this whole thing out, it'll just fold back over, and then we can slide this thing out and still have the truck again. So So this is the fill port for the water. I did not want to run the fill port out of the truck and make any permanent holes in the bed at all. So we just dragged a hose in here and fill that. And then the little tube on the side is the vent. So while we're filling it, it has a place to vent. The water tank is down below. You can't see it, but it's underneath the bed box here, underneath this wood, and it's built into the bed box. So the water tank isn't gonna go anywhere. It's basically on either end, it's captivated. On either end, there's wood plates that hold it in. And then on the top, I shimmed the top of this deck up to just be a quarter inch over the top of the water tank. So it is not strapped in, but it's not going anywhere. This is the shelf that we use for just oddities. When we're getting in and out of the truck, when we're sleeping in here, we put our wallet, stuff, phones, change, whatever, just little stuff, hats, gloves, those kind of things. And then attached to those shelves below are these fans. These fans are absolutely amazing. They're a huge game changer with the heater. They swivel down, they can swivel back. I can blow air out. I can suck air in through this window here. I can move the fans. I can slide them in and out on this bracket that I made. And then they just turn on with the little cable just runs down over to the 12 volt port down over there. What it does is the Mr. Buddy heater, the heat comes out of the Mr. Buddy and it just goes straight up to the roof because there's nothing moving it. And so essentially what these do is I just twist them both this way and it blows the air around kind of in a circle, and it helps distribute the heat considerably more evenly than it is distributed with just the Mr. Buddy. So on this side of the bed storage, I've got these plates that lift up. This one lifts up here, that's where our air compressor goes. This one lifts up, but there's nothing underneath it. And then this one lifts up here, and there's some tool storage beneath here. I've got a toolbox, I've got a rope, a rag, and some electrical tidbits, just stuff that we don't use a lot of. And then this one folds up and it just rests. Put these little furniture rests on there, and then these little plates down here. So if you fold the center one up, they all fold up. But essentially these fold up so I can pull this whole thing out of the truck. It is not bolted down and is not mounted. It's heavy enough to where it doesn't go anywhere. But I wanted to be able to pull it in and out very easily. So those things just go down, and then we put the mattress right over the top of them, and that works. So you can see the reflectix in the windows here. Basically what we did was we cut the reflectix to fit and then just gen sewed on Velcro onto the back of it, and they just Velcro right up to the around the windows. I'm sure it makes a pretty good difference. When we have the heater on, there's condensation, of course, from us breathing and the warmth, and when it's cold outside, and that condensation is on the glass of the windows, but it does not get on the reflectix at all. So I'm sure there's some sort of element of heat retention that the reflectix gives us. Not to mention the roof of this is actually insulated. I don't know if you can see, but there's a little bit of a ledge here. And this part is this honeycomb, and it's also carpeted, which makes a big difference too. So we've been in here at nights when we woke up, and the coldest we've been in was minus 13 F when we woke up in the morning. And generally it's about 5 degrees warmer in the truck, and there were icicles hanging from the carpet inside of the truck until we turned the heater on and they melted. So this is the main switch to kill all the power in the back of the truck. There's a big fat cable. Well, it's fat. It's like an 8-gauge cable, 10-gauge cable that comes up to this and is fused off the battery. This turns off everything. And then that is all fed to this fuse box. This fuse box is what distributes the power in the back of the truck. Each of these circuits all has its own fuse. The fuses are rated varying depending upon what we need for that circuit. And so I made these leather straps a couple of weeks ago, and when we're in the back of the truck, it's very nice to have these straps to be able to pull on to close the door. And you can see one down there on the bed. The mounting system on this one on the bed is not awesome. It's just screwed into one of the existing screws for the tailgate access plate. Probably going to come up with something a little bit better, a little more aesthetic for that. So these are the drawers. This is what holds all of our gear.
that we need when we go out in the woods. It has our kitchen gear, food, it's got our stove, lots of stuff is in these drawers, and everything stays in there. And so it's very nice to have all of that already in the truck, ready to go. So if we want to go away for a weekend, all we need to do is throw the fridge, the battery, a table, propane, and we're out the door.
So each drawer's got a latch like this so it doesn't fly open. You just click this latch open, pull this drawer, and there is everything. Well, not everything, because the stove's out. We have a Frisbee for Can Jam, which is one of the most amazing games ever. This is an adjustable fire grill that my boys got me for Christmas. Here is our cooking stuff. And then back here is our survival kit. This has survival gear. We got mountain houses and liquor, so we can make it through just about anything. And let's get this drawer opened up. So this drawer has our chairs. This is our dry bag that we use for a garbage can, scrub daddy. This is our portable table. We use these floor mats, these little rug mats, for when we're changing. If we go camping by ourselves, it's nice to be able to change not inside of there because you can't stand up. And so I put one of these outside of each door. And then what we do is we just go put our bags in front of each door, and then we put this down, and that way we can put our shoes on the ground over here, and then we can step on this with our socks or bare feet or whatever, and we don't get all dirty. And they just store right in here really well. Kind of keeps the lids on these things too. Each of these has different things that we need for camping, fire stuff, kitchen stuff in the other one. This is just utilities all the way back. There's toilet paper, there's other things in each of these, but they fit in here perfect. They latch down. I don't really need to latch them too much, but all of our stuff's in these drawers. So the rails on the drawers that slide in and out are super strut, which I got at Home Depot. It's actually cheaper than using square tubing, and actually probably a little heavier duty. And then these rollers in the bed here are just skateboard wheel bearings. Did some research online, found a couple people that have built these before, and it worked out really well. And you can see that the rollers work really well. Once I get it moving, it just slides right in and closes. Put a little latch on it. These drawers aren't going anywhere. So the bed box I made on my own. I am no woodsman. This is the most ambitious wood project I've ever done. The top plate is 3/4 inch plywood. The rest of it is all 1/2 inch. The sides are 1/2 inch, and then on the bottoms, you can't see in here, but there's little slats that fit in the grooves of the bed down in here. You can see the grooves here because the bed's got little groove spots. So these little slats fit in the grooves. That way it doesn't slide side to side. There's enough weight in here to where I don't have to worry about this thing moving around at all. It has never gone anywhere. I got this little aluminum plate up here just for edge protection. And then on the top, I put this rubber diamond plate flooring stuff for protection also. And I've used this a couple times for storage. You know, my kids come over and borrow the truck and use it for moving furniture or whatever. And this works out really well. So the mattress that we used is one we got on Amazon. It's actually King's Camp, and it is an inflatable mattress. It's self-inflating. Right now, these valves are open, and you can see that it's got a whole bunch of squish in here. So once we blow it up a little bit, put a little pressure in it, it's actually very comfortable. And then the pillows that we have, which are stored in the shelf over here from the same company, they also work very well. They're kind of small, so we usually bring one pillow from home. Okay, now to the kitchen. This is where we do all of our food preparation. This is where we store our food. Right now I've got this sweet fire going because it's 34 degrees out here and we're a little cold. I'll talk a little bit more about the stove. So the stove is from Camp Chef. It's Camp Chef Ranger 2. It's 34,000 BTUs, so it's got plenty of heat that comes out of it. It's cast iron on the top. It's very durable. I put this little 90 degree fitting on here so we can run the hose, because the hose just used to come out this way and then I'd have to run it around the back. So I ended up getting a 90 degree fitting, so the hose just runs down this way and then goes around the back, goes down to the propane tank. So now I'll talk about food storage and power. This is a fridge. It's from Ice Cove. It's a 40 liter fridge slash freezer. It runs off of our battery, which I'll talk about here in a second around the corner. This fridge is the best. We've had three. The first fridge we had was from Alpacool. It was a 20 liter. It worked great. It just, we ran out of space. It was a little bit too small. We ended up bringing the fridge and a cooler, and we wanted to avoid bringing the cooler. So we upgraded to a Bodega 40, 38 liter fridge, and that thing was junk. We used it one weekend. It wouldn't even go below 30. It was running the entire time trying to keep it 30. We ended up fighting with Amazon and the Bodega people to get that thing returned, but eventually we got it returned. We ended up upgrading or buying this Iceco, and this thing is amazing. It works great. It just sips energy. It's not too bad at all. It works out really well. So this is our power source. Inside of this toolbox is a Wise 100 amp hour lithium iron phosphate battery. You can just see the top of the battery there. There's insulation all around it because I've got heaters, which are actually on right now. The battery powers this SAE plug here. There are two USB ports that have multiple USBs in them here. This is an amp hour meter. It tells me how many amp hours are left in the battery. It tells me percentage. It's the same because it's a 100 amp hour battery. It tells me how many amp hours or how many amps are being used at the time, and then gives me the voltage. We typically just leave it on the amps being used so we can watch usage. This is an SAE plug. I have another SAE plug over here. This is the one that plugs into the fridge. The fridge from the factory has a 12 volt plug that went into this socket, but it would pop out and I didn't like it very much. It wasn't very secure. So I cut the end off and soldered on this SAE plug connector for the fridge. And then the solar has an SAE, and the solar just plugs into this side. Every single one of these circuits is fused. As you can see here, all of these are fuses. And then there's actually a couple more down below underneath. On the sides of the battery, you can't see them, but I have these little RV elbow heaters to keep the battery warm. The battery can be used all the way down to -4°F, but it cannot be charged below 32. The BMS inside of the battery box will shut that down. So I bought this little temperature controller, ran it down inside, and the wire, the temperature probe for the temperature controller, I drilled a small hole in the side of the battery and stuck it inside. Then when I turn this on, this is in Celsius, I can set whatever temperature I want it to come on and turn off. And I usually have it set to come on at about 38 and then go off at about 45. So it's a pretty narrow range, but that's plenty of temperature. And then I have all this insulation in here to keep the temperature in the box. So last but not least, this is our awning. We got this awning from Napa. It is a MaxiTrack awning. It was $110. It is basically a copy of the ARB awning that they make. That's the 8-foot awning. It mounts up to the truck over there. And then I actually bought, this is just part of it, but I bought the ARB awning room, and it fits on here perfectly. So anytime we go camping with a group, we don't want to change in the back of the truck because it's kind of a pain. We just put the awning room up, got a whole other room. It's private. You can't see in. We can change in there. We put the setup in there to cook. We cook in there. It actually works out really well. This awning has been through some serious stuff. It's snow, sleet, rain, hail, whatever. When it rains out, we just tilt one end down. That way the rain runs off and goes down off there. We've had it in storms so bad that I actually had to dig a hole down in the ground here, not a hole, but a trough to run the water away because so much water was running off the awning that it was filling up and causing water to go everywhere. So this thing's been through some stuff and it actually works really well considering that it's not very expensive and it's probably a Chinese copy of the ARB. For the price that we paid, it's absolutely amazing. One custom thing we did to the awning was we added these USB lights. We got those from actually Big Five Sporting Goods, and there's one up there and there's one back here, and those are, they're really good ambient light. They don't shine enough light to be able to do any sort of filming or anything like that, but the ambient light, it's great. It's just like a little medium duty porch light. We turn those on at night, and if we're away, you know, 20, 30 yards away from camp, we can see our truck, walk right to it. You generally don't need a flashlight. So they work out really well. We love them. And what we use to power these are just USB powered. You can see this USB connector here. Up here on the top of the truck, I just put a solar rechargeable USB power bank, and it works out really well. And if it's raining outside, I just put it in a bag. So the water doesn't get in there. this a little red. Got ya. Anyway, all right, guys, that wraps up the walk around of the truck for now. If you have any questions, if you have any comments, if you want more details about any of the stuff that I went over in the video, leave a comment below. I'll go into detail on anything you guys ask about, the battery, the truck box, any of the gear that I listed in there, questions, it's great. So put those in the comments below and make sure and like, make sure and subscribe. We're a super small channel and that stuff always helps. So that's it for today. We'll see you guys in the next video.
See you in the outside.
I'm too old for this.